Conference is being recorded.
Thank you. what's wrong with her?
Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord, for tonight. We welcome your Holy Spirit's presence and anointing on this prayer line. And Lord, we thank you for the opportunity that you give us to pray for your people on this prayer line. Lord, we lift up Sister Cynthia, who will be sharing the word tonight. Anoint her lips as she brings forth the message, Lord God. We pray that your name would be glorified and honored on this prayer line tonight. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
May call on Sister Cynthia.
Thank you. Yes. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I was on the line and somebody, I think Margaret is trying to get on and she just cut me off.
Oh.
Anyway. Yeah. Well, I mean, she came into my line.
Oh, all right.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Good evening, all. Good evening, brethren.
Good evening.
Good evening. How is everyone today?
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Good, yeah.
Amen.
Good weather, good weather, good weather. We thank God for another day like today, which never was before. Today is today. And we thank him for the good weather, we thank him for our lives, and we thank him again for the privilege
Amen. That
it is to us to come on this prayer line and to be able to try and to take the gospel over to unbelievers and even to our own selves. So we thank God for this, for his every provision, for making this possible every week and so many days in the week. We give him thanks. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Let us pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, how grateful we are as your servants. How grateful we are, O God, that we are amongst the called and the chosen, O God. And so we ask, Lord, unless your grace abounds in our life, Lord, we would bring you no glory even if we have been chosen. So we want you to just thank you, Lord, that you are with us. Grace is provided abundantly, O God, that we can keep doing the work that we ought to do now that it is day, O Lord God. And that you are glorified in every effort that we make, O God, to serve you and to preach the gospel. Lord, we thank you for keeping our families. We thank you for your provision for us and our families. We thank you, O God, for taking away all fear from our hearts, O God. The fear that is coming from the intimidation of the activities of the evil one and the world, O God. But we thank you for the peace and the rest you give to us because our mind is stayed on you. We give you thanks, and tonight we ask that we invite you, Holy Spirit, to come down and take control, take charge. I bring myself under the blood, and I ask that you will speak through me, O God, to send your word forward. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Tonight we are looking at a topic. Sons of God march forward, propelled by a belief system. Sons of God march forward, propelled by a belief system. And we just look at John 1:12. And this is the only text we're going to read. The others are references that you would read in your own time. In the book of John, Chapter 1 and verses 12 tells us, but as many as received him, to them gave he power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name. Amen. To many as received him, to them gave he power to become the sons of God. Hallelujah. And we are looking at a belief system that propels us to become a son of God. When I checked in the, not in the encyclopedia, I checked on the internet, and they gave a definition here from Wikipedia, and it says, every human being has a belief system that they utilize, and it's through this mechanism that we individually make sense. Mutually supportive beliefs, such as religious, philosophical, or ideological. This was a definition from Wikipedia. So then, that's it, it's finished. Now I'm saying then a belief system is steeped into spirituality. Our belief system is steeped into spirituality, not religiosity, as Wikipedia did mention. And it is our belief system shaped in religiosity that would shape the core of your thoughts. And from your thoughts, we develop habits. And from our habits, we develop character. And from character, character will shape our destiny. Hallelujah. We are looking at how your belief system or the sons of God, how their belief system changed them to become sons of God. And your belief system, I'm saying, will shape the core of your thoughts, your habits. Your thoughts bring forth your habits. Your habits will influence or shape your character, and your character will in turn shape your destiny. In the verse we just read, John 1:12, it's about God, sons of God. And the verse says, receive, but as many as receive. There is a condition. The condition is receive. But as many as receive, they were given the power to become. The power to live like a son of God. The power to look as a son of God. If only they believed in his name. There's something that we need to know, and that is sonship often involves transfer. I said often because it's not every son or daughter gets an inheritance or inherits. So I say sonship often involves a transfer from father to son. It might be a transfer of wealth, possession, sometimes fame, because if your father is famous or is known or is an icon in some world, then people look at you also in a different way. But there is one inheritance that all sons automatically inherit, and that is the father's name, unless he is a bastard. But even so, if the father's name is Joe Thompson, the son is a Joe Thompson. He comes from that family, regardless of what the land, the law of that land might be. So there's one thing a son definitely inherits, and that is the name. He inherits the father's name. And the Bible gives us example of the transfer of an inheritance to a son. We have in the book of Luke chapter 15, we remember that story, we have the prodigal son who asked his father for his inheritance. So there is the example of inheritance from father to a son. And we also have in the book of Genesis chapter 12 verses 7, God's promise of wealth to Abraham's seed. Hallelujah. Transfer from son, from father to son. So God has promised his sons in John 1:12 an inheritance through his own son, Jesus Christ. But you know what? Before Christ Jesus came on the scene, God had endued us, or our first parents, Adam and Eve, with power. This is what God said in Genesis 1:27. It said, man was created in his own image, which is the image of God. So we had already inheritance right back from the Garden of Eden. And there was a transfer, as you know. So we are sons of God, as mentioned in John 1:12. Do we know that we are sons of God? And if we know that we are sons of God, knowing and believing are two different things. This is why the verse tells us, whosoever believeth and receive, you become a son. So do you know that you're a son of God? Do you believe that you're a son of God? God said in his word, if you believe. Now, we want to see what will shape our belief. We are looking at how we become sons of God, as mentioned in John 1:12. What can shape that belief system to make us become sons of God? Brethren, is just one thing, and that is faith. The Bible tells us faith cometh by hearing, and hearing the word of God. So to be a son of God, there has to be faith. Faith in God. Faith in God, and faith in God is reflected in his word. So we have to have, when we hear the word, we have to have faith in it. Faith, then, is the first building block of salvation. The first building block of salvation is faith. Without faith, it is impossible to please God. Without faith, nothing can be started on your behalf so far as salvation goes. The new belief system that you're going to have as your have faith in the word of God, a new belief system will redirect and reassess the world that you live in. And we know from our own experience, if you're truly born again, you know that this new belief system redirects and reassesses the world that we live in. And many of us today know that if we are one of his, We know all that is going on in the world today. We can see it with our spiritual eyes. The Word of God bears testimony to this. Hallelujah. And so, as we reassess and redirect our pathway in the world that we live in, it will have to involve the following. As I said, it starts with faith, the building block of salvation, and then this belief system will this new belief system will redirect and reassess the world that we live in. And this will involve the mind. The Bible tells us that we must have a new mindset, the mind of Christ. It will involve the mind. Secondly, it will involve a new heart, as described in Ezekiel 36:26, I think. It would not be like the heart, the old heart that we had, as described in the book of Jeremiah and Galatians. That heart will be no more. We will have a new heart. Ezekiel 36. And let me read what it says, because I used to love this. This is Ezekiel 36. A new heart will I give to you. Ezekiel 36. 26. I'm going to read it for you. A new heart and spirit. It says, holy name. Okay, I read from verse 26. It says, a new heart also will I give you, and a new spirit will I put within you. And I will take away the stony heart out of your flesh, and I will give you a heart of flesh. Hallelujah. This is the heart. We are dealing with sons of God and the belief system, how it's being influenced and shaped. So Ezekiel 36:26 just tells us about the new heart that God is going to give. Then we have to deal, the belief system has to deal with the world. The system, the world, meaning the systems that man and Satan have evolved. All that we see about us and all around us is attributed to Satan and man. And a fifth point that we have to deal with when we have got this new belief system, it is the gospel as proclaimed by Jesus Christ that leads on to salvation, that leads on to rest, and that leads on to eternal life. Hallelujah, hallelujah. So we would say what goes into the making of sons of God. And so we want to know, how do sons of God march forward? As we go over the points again, we know that sons of God must have the mind of Christ. Sons of God must have a new heart. For out of the heart flows the issues of life, we are told. And we are also told in Jeremiah 4:3 that the fallow grounds of the heart must be broken up and no more sown among thorns. Which of course goes back to the world again. another point we get dealt with was, the Bible tells us not to love the world and all that therein is. For the world passeth away, the fashions, the emulations, the loves and the hate and the lust, and all unbiblical doctrinal systems, technological systems, the whole gamut of it, they will pass away, but only the Word of God remains. All will pass away, the Bible tells us, but God said, my Word shall not pass away. Another point we saw was the devil, Satan. He too would be bound up for 1,000 years in the bottomless pit. Well, you know what? Satan knows his fate. He knows that he's going to be bound up. He knows he's been tried and already. He knows his fate. But how about you? Do you know for sure? You meet so often people saying, I know. Are you sure you're going to heaven? How do you know you're going to heaven? Yes, I'm going to heaven. And they have not taken the steps forward to go to heaven, either in ignorance or just being stubborn. Satan knows his fate already. But do you know for sure your destiny? Let me say, if you are not yet born again and baptized in the Holy Ghost, your destiny is one that leads, should you pass away, should the rapture come, your destiny leads you away from the presence of God eternally. Hell is then your destination. But if you have a new belief system based in God's word, you will have a change of destiny. Receive, believe the word of God, and become a son of God. Hallelujah. And the last point was, lastly, receive Christ Jesus into your life as you repent. Jesus Christ must now take preeminence in all of your life. Every effort, everything, in your waking moments, in your sleeping moments, in your thinking, in your loves, in everything, saturated with Jesus Christ, your Savior, your Redeemer. And here is what it says in John 10, and I read for you. For Christ is the door when he enters in. When he enters in, you will be saved. This is the promise. John 10:9. And the verse went on to say, you would be saved and find pasture. Find pasture in the Lord Jesus. When he enters in, you will find pasture. Have you observed the animals grazing in the green pastures? If those of you come from rural areas or islands where this is familiar scene, have you ever, if you can reflect, have you ever seen, if you look at these animals grazing in the green pastures, there is a sort of quietness and contentment about them. There is a sort of confidence that they have in the shepherd. Hallelujah. Jesus said, find pasture in him. And meaning, you will find rest in him. Just as the animals in the green pastures find rest, so too, when Jesus comes in via the Holy Spirit, you too will find rest in him. And even Isaiah 26:3 tells us, He will keep us in perfect peace as our minds is stayed upon Him. Brethren, sons of God have a new belief system that has changed their lives. Their lives are changed. Their belief system no longer conforms to the world, but is transformed by the renewal of the mind. Romans 12:2. So, as sons of God, we must move forward through the blood of Jesus because of our new belief system. And we know that we say in some songs that we are winners when we run with Christ, because He is the victorious one. He gained the victory for us. So we are runners. And as sons of God, with a new belief system, which begins with faith, which begins with a changed mindset, which begins with a heart that is no more hardened, but has been broken up, which begins with reassessing the world, which begins with recognizing the devil for who he is, and which begins with total surrender to the Lord Jesus Christ, the Word of God, the Word of God. Amen. Hallelujah. So this is tonight's message. When we say we are sons of God, marching forward, sons of God in John 1:12, this is it. Sons of God must have received a new belief system, must, or they are not sons of God. The new belief system, which does not conform to the world anymore, but transforms into a new creation, God's creation. Hallelujah. Let us pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, we want to just thank you again, O Lord, for enlightening us, O God. That we will not read the scriptures superficially, O God, but Thou will give us the grace and the understanding, O God, and even the wisdom in what we are reading, O Lord God. So because in these evil times, we know, O God, we have been threatened already, and it would be that the word, your word, can become scarce. But when your word is hidden in our hearts, as David said, Thy word have I hidden in my heart, that I may not sin against thee. But we can go on further, Lord, and be confident when we say that your word will be hidden in our hearts, and no man can take it from it, from our hearts. So we pray tonight, O God, as we continue on the journey, give us more understanding, O God. Increase us in wisdom as to this journey, as to your kingdom and all that is required of us. This is the time for us to work, O God. Help us to remember, and may your grace be added unto our lives every day, making it urgent, giving us that spirit of urgency to go out. Souls are perishing and dying because of neglect. Souls are perishing and dying because of ignorance. But Lord, we pray that the souls of men would not be counted against us on that great day, as stated in Ezekiel. So we pray tonight for each one of us, O God. Place this burden upon our hearts, O God. Men are dying every day and dying without Christ. God forbid that anyone should have passed our way and we were not able to help. Father, tonight we want to just thank you again, O God, for keeping us together, uniting us together, knitting us together. We want to just thank you again this night, oh Father God, for this program. We want to just thank you again for all your servants involved in it, oh God. Lord, we ask that, oh Lord, even as we ask that you increase us in knowledge and give us wisdom, oh Lord, to decipher. We ask the same, oh Lord, for our leaders, oh God. May you continue to bless them, upgrade them, and keep them by your mighty power and in your love. Tonight, we say thank you again. Thank you in the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Sister Cynthia, for that word. Once again, the lesson for tonight is titled Sons of God March Forward Through the Blood of Jesus. From John 1.
No. Sons of God march forward, propelled by a new belief system.
Oh, true.
I know the song says, Sons of God March Forward to the Blood of Jesus. But the title of the message is Sons of God March Forward, Propelled by a New Belief System.
Amen, amen. And our scripture reading came from John 1, 12. Verse 12. Hallelujah. I hope you've been taking notes. We have a few of those scripture readings that she mentioned. But if you want to listen to the full message, our website is glorytabernacleprayermeeting.blogspot.com. Hallelujah. Thank you, Sister Cynthia, for that word.
You're welcome.
Hallelujah. We are now in the portion of taking your prayer requests. Once again, this is Glory Tabernacle Healing and Deliverance Prayer Line together with the Consuming Fire Radio Ministry. We are broadcasted globally tonight, and to all our listeners, even the silent listeners, our prayer intercessors, our listeners from abroad and here, the line is open for you now. I have the first prayer request. Do you have any prayer requests or praise report? Hello? Go ahead.
I forget your name, yes? Good afternoon. Hi, this is the... What's her name again? I forget her name.
Who is this?
Margaret Fuller.
Oh, hi, Sister Margaret.
How are you? Okay.
God bless. Hallelujah.
Thank you. I'm requesting prayer for my sister, Carol, for mine. Prayers that God will continue to heal her mind. She's schizophrenic. And that she'll be able to do things on her own. And I'm requesting prayers that I'm not going to be here on the second. I'll be away for a whole month.
Okay.
And returning back the 17th of September. I just ask God for God's protection and guidance.
Amen. Okay. May I call on Sister Claire? Can you please slip up Sister Margaret is traveling and coming back in September. Also for her sister Clara, that God will heal her mind. Okay.
Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord, for tonight. We thank you, Lord, for letting us pray for your people. And Lord, we lift up, we first thank you for the word that you gave us through Sister Cynthia. We pray that it bless your people tonight, Lord. Mm-hmm. We lift up Sister Margaret and her prayer request for Sister Clara. And Lord, we pray, Lord God, that you would continue to heal her mind, Lord God, set her free completely, and Lord, let her be independent, Lord God. And Lord, we also pray, Lord, for complete healing and restoration, Lord. Lord, we also pray for Sister Margaret, for traveling mercy as she goes away for a month, Lord God. Guide her, protect her, Lord God, as she travels. And Lord, we pray, Lord God, your blessing upon her and her family. We pray for salvation of every member of her household, Lord God, that they may come to know you as their Lord and Savior, Lord. Lord, bless her life, Lord. Continue to use her as a witness and a testimony to everyone she knows, Lord God. Let them see the light of Jesus in her, Lord, that your name would be glorified and honored. And Lord, we lift her up to you tonight. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Thank you, Sister Margaret.
Thank you.
Who else is on the prayer line with a prayer request or a praise report? I call on Sister Lila. Sister Lila. Anybody else with a prayer request or a praise report? Mr. Cheat, are you on? Mr. Lai, are you on?
Hi, Pastor Marina. Good evening.
Oh, hi. Do you have any prayer requests or a praise report?
Actually, I need prayers because of my two knees, which are really hurting me since Sunday. The two knees, I have a hard time walking. Thank you.
I cannot hear you. What is it again?
Oh, my two knees are hurting. It's really bad. Thank you.
Oh, okay. Both knees. All right. How is Sister Grace?
Oh, she's getting better. Yesterday, I overheard from Sister Sajuta. I think she's getting better now. So I hope she will come back soon to New York. Okay. Thank you for the prayers.
So she'll be back in New York.
I hope so, but I'm not sure yet. I will follow it up to Sister Sarah, Pastor Marina.
Okay, God bless you.
God bless, thank you.
So we have to lift up all our brothers and sisters who are sick. Also, Sister Lila, her both knees are hurting. Even all the silent listeners in our prayer line who are sick tonight. Let's also remember
those who are undergoing therapy or continues with their what's this? They have continued their therapy and all kinds of that they're going through. Let's call on Sister Chit. Can you lift up all the sick tonight?
Sister Marina?
Hi, Sister Chit. Can we lift up all the sick tonight? Also, Sister Lila, her knees are hurting her. Also, Sister Rita, her brother and her uncle. And Sister Grace is recuperating, they said. And we haven't heard from Sister Juliet again. I don't know what's going on. And also include our sister Rosemary. She's undergoing dental repairs. Okay. Thank you.
Lord, thank you so much. Oh, God, Jesus, thank you for your goodness. Thank you for your faithfulness. Lord, thank you for the strength that you have given us today, Lord Jesus. Oh, God, you are a faithful God. You are a God who always see our needs. Oh, God, you will touch our bodies and make us whole. You are the God who heals. Oh, Lord Jesus, and by your stripes we are healed. Father, in the name of Jesus, I lift up to you, Sister Lila. I lift up to you, Sister Juliet. I lift up to you, Sister Rita. I lift up to you, Lord. Oh, God, all the people that Sister Pastor Marina mentioned, Lord, we know them by name. And I lift up to you, Lord God, all those who are sick at this hour, whatever they're going through, my God. You know what they're going through, Lord Jesus. Oh, God, Lord, Almighty Father, sickness, Lord, it's not too hard for you to touch and heal, Lord. And tonight, Lord, I pray that your Holy Spirit will touch this one and that your healing power will be upon our bodies and make us whole. Give us strength. Touch those every ligament. Touch those knees that are hurting. Touch those, oh God, those with arthritis, oh God. Mm. With diabetes tissue, Lord, Sister Rita, Lord. Touch those, Lord God, who have high blood pressure, Lord. Oh, yes. God. Touch, oh Lord, who have vascular diseases, Lord Jesus. Oh, God, high blood pressure, Lord Jesus. Father, Almighty God, nothing is too hard for you to do. So, Lord, tonight, Lord, do a miracle in this prayer line. Let healing take place, Lord God Almighty. Father, oh God, Jesus, there's power in your name. There's healing in your name. And right now, Lord, we pray for your miracle of healing, Lord. Touch each one in this prayer line and let them, Lord, exalt your name and testify of your goodness and your faithfulness and your miracles, oh God. Lord, thank you so much for answering our prayer tonight. And by faith, Lord, oh God, we claim our healing, oh God, individually and collectively, Lord Jesus. Father, thank you. We are so grateful, Lord God, for the many, many answered prayers in this prayer line, my God. Lord, I lift up to you every family in this prayer line. Protect it, Lord. Oh, God, the enemy wants to destroy, to kill, and to steal. But, Father, you came to give us life and have it abundantly. Lord, let you be the center of every home, every family, Lord. Every husband and wife, strengthen the relationship, my God. Bring love and peace and harmony and unity in the home, Lord. Oh, God, those who are not saved, may they be saved. Oh, God, as they see Jesus through those who are saved. Father, I pray, oh, God, Lord, Oh, Lord, there are so many issues regarding families, Lord, regarding marriages, Lord, but marriage is for a man and a woman, Lord. Let it be so, Lord God, Father Almighty. Oh, Lord, let your will, let your word prevail in this hour, my God, Lord. Bring conviction and bring, oh God, salvation. Bring them from the kingdom of darkness to the kingdom of light, so that, Lord, revival will come from within. And if revival is started from within, Lord, there will be power, will be transformation, Lord. Oh, God, of the within the person and within the society. Oh, Lord, let there be the unity, in unity with the Holy Spirit, oh, God. Holy Spirit, we pray that you move and have your hand hover over all, oh God, Lord Jesus, that, Lord, people will repent and call upon your name, oh God, Jesus, and pray and seek your face, oh God, Lord, Almighty God. Bring revival to this nation once again, Lord Jesus, and I thank you. I thank you for this prayer, my God. I thank you, Lord, for Pastor Mal and Pastor Marina. I thank you, Lord God, for your presence in this prayer line, Lord. May your, oh God, presence, may your spirit move mightily in this prayer line and touch people, Lord, in this prayer line, those who have not heard the gospel, Lord. The gospel, Lord, that you died on the cross for us, that you love us so much, that you gave your life for us, so that we will be redeemed of our sins. Oh, Lord, Father, that whosoever, oh God, believe in you, Lord Jesus, then you gave them the power to become children of God, and you will live in within the person, Lord. And, oh God, thank you so much. Bless each one in this prayer line. Bless Pastor Mel and Pastor Marina, oh God. We love you, Jesus. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen, amen. Thank you, Sister Chief. Anybody else on the prayer line with a prayer request?
Hi, Pastor Marina. The son. Pastor Marina.
Go ahead.
The son, the two sons of my landlady, Sultan and Daniel, they went to Nepal to volunteer on for the earthquake victims. So she is asking for our prayers for their safety. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you, Sister Lai. Anybody else on the prayer line with a prayer request or a praise report?
Yes, another prayer request that I have for two sisters in the Lord, Sister Marina. Yes, her name is Emma, who is suffering from her back. She has a slip disc, and the doctor tell her she would have to have surgery. So yeah. She's in a lot of pain. Tomorrow she goes to get her back brace. So I just want you to lift her up in prayers for me, for her. And another sister, Elaine, she suffers from her right foot bothers her all the time. I think it's post circulation, and she has some veins on her legs that, you know, it swells up, and it bothers her, so she always be in pain. And I just, you know, ask the Lord to heal her and bring healing to her body. Okay. In Jesus' name.
Okay, go ahead, Sister.
Heavenly Father, we lift up Sister Margaret, Lord God, and her prayer request for healing for Emma and Lynn, Lord. We pray for Emma that you heal her back, Lord. this, Lord God. Lord, we pray for complete healing and restoration, Lord God. And Lord, we pray for Lynn and her foot, that you bring circulation back into her leg, Lord. And Lord, take away the swelling and heal her completely, Lord God. Bring complete healing and restoration, Lord. Lord, we also lift up Sister Lila's prayer request, Lord God. We pray, Lord God, for you to guide and direct the sons of the landlady that as they go to volunteer, Lord, in the earthquake in Nepal, that, Lord, you would protect them, guide them, direct them. Lord, give them your traveling mercy, Lord God, and give them your protection, Lord. And, Lord, we thank you, Lord, for the heart that you've given them to volunteer during this disaster, Lord God. Bless them there, Lord. And, Lord, bless all those who are willing to help those people, Lord God. Lord, we thank you for your goodness, your mercy, your grace, Lord God. Lord, we also lift up, Lord God, this prayer line, Lord God. We thank you for every prayer intercessor that prays for your people. And Lord, we pray that as we lift up the needs of your people, there will be a praise report and a testimony of how you've answered the prayer requests. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you, Sister Margaret.
Yes, thank you.
Okay. Anybody else on the prayer line with a prayer request or a praise report? I just want to encourage everyone as we continue to seek the Lord, also as we obey Him and as we are faithful in our walk with Him, God will reward us. And I'm so happy to share with you that we are blessed. We have been blessed in our church and by a sister, and to God be the glory. She is a wonderful sister, and as she bless us, we can bless others too. And I want to thank the Lord. I want to thank Him for the encouragement in our life. And Lord, teach us how to build others up, to encourage them in the precious faith you have imparted. Let us encourage our neighbors for their good works, to build them up, as well as to help others, Lord, as you help us, Lord God. And Lord, we let us remember all the good things that you have shared to us, that you have promised us, Lord God. And let us show others how to be of good cheer, Lord God, for you have overcome the world. Even though we have tribulation in the world, in you, Lord, we have peace. Help us, Lord, to share your peace with others. Lord, it is our goal to follow after the things that make for peace, the things wherewith we will be able to edify and encourage others. May your people always be encouraged but by what we say and do. Let our words always edify and minister grace, and let our life be an encouragement at all times. We give you all the praise and the glory, God, and help us to comfort others with the same comfort we have received from you. Give you all the glory and the grace. We love you, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Anybody else on the prayer line with a prayer request or a praise report?
Hello, good evening, Pastor Marina.
Oh, hi, Sister Connie. Praise the Lord.
I was trying to be a silent listener, but I'm at work right now, so I called while I'm working.
Do you have anything to share with us? Or
I would like to quickly share with what the Lord is doing in our life and in my family and also in my village. We undergo right now, we are started the process of rebuilding the church that has been destroyed. So now we are making bricks, and I want to praise God because the people in the church, participate in doing a volunteer work on making the bricks. And I want to thank God because it is God's way, and He is providing for materials, and He is also providing for the workers. And I would like to share with everybody that just open your life to the Lord and let the Lord do a work in your life, because there is nothing too hard, and God will make it happen. And all the time, by 100%, it has to be all God. And we can't say we're going to help, because how are you going to help a mighty God, a mighty provider? So all we have to do is just open ourselves and let God move and let God work in our life, and just submit ourselves and not put our intelligence in and mingle with God's intelligence. So I would like to share with everybody that anybody can be used by God. And I want to encourage everybody. You don't have to have a big capital of money to do anything. God started with a word. He spoke the word, and the world become a world. The earth become an earth, and then life become life. He spoke the word. So I just want to leave that encouragement to everybody, not to let your understanding, your own understanding, hold you back, because whoever... is anyone out there that is holding back, I would advise that you will submit yourself and let God use you in a mighty way, because you never know what the possibility until you submit and let God use you. God can use anybody. If you can speak, God will use you with your voice. If you can move your hand, God will use your hand. If you can walk, God will use your feet. God will use you in any way that you are possible. So I just want to leave everyone with an encouragement that all things are possible for those who love God. God makes everything beautiful. And I would just like to leave this encouragement to everybody that Jesus died for us already, and He opened the door, so nothing is going to hold us back. And God said He will rebuild the mountain for us, just so His purpose can go through, can be accomplished. So there, I want to tell everybody that we are all in the body of Christ, and God loves us unconditionally, and in the same way, we are all loved by God. And there is no measure, there is no greater. He loves us just as much as He loved me, as He loved you, and every one of us. And I want to give glory to the Lord Jesus Christ, our Savior. And that is my sharing. Amen.
Amen, amen. Thank you, Sister Connie. What an encouragement. Hallelujah. Anybody else with a praise report or an encouraging word for all of us? May I call on Sister Lila?
Yes, Pastor Marina.
Hi, can we lift up our nation and all our leaders tonight? Also those who need salvation, okay?
Okay. Heavenly Father, we thank you for tonight, Lord God, for bringing us together in this prayer line. Thank you, Lord, for answering all our petitions, all our cries. Thank you for the so many healing miracles that you are extending to us in this through this prayer line, Lord God. We lift up the United States, the nation where we are at now, Lord God. You have put us in this nation to be a missionary, Lord God, out from our own county, the Philippines, Lord. May you use all the those who are in Lord, we pray and lift up all the officials of this county, from the president down to the smallest, to the smallest position in the government, Lord, that they may look up to you, Lord God, as the head of this nation, as the head of the state, Lord God, not a man, but you as a God, Lord God. Lord, there are so many things that is going around us, Lord, but we trust in you that you will be in control of everything, Lord God. There are so many movements. The enemy is coming in, controlling, building a statue, and the marriage between men and men and woman, Lord God. The abortion problem, the drug problem, Lord God. There are so many problems, Lord God. Have mercy, Lord, on your people. Have mercy on the officers and all those people in persons in the position, Lord, of the in the government, that they may take the solution and measure that is according to your word and according to your most holy will, Lord God. We pray for the salvation of this county, Lord God. The people who are still blind and who doesn't know you, Lord God, and those who are falling away. Lord, please send your angels. Please send your ministering angels, Lord God, and people who can minister to them, Lord God, your word, that they may open their eyes, that there is really a God, Lord, that you are the God who created us, and you are the God who provides for all our needs, that you are the God who heals us when we are sick. You are the God who provides everything, Lord God, in our life. Save the people, Lord God. May they look upon you. May they find out that there is really an eternal life through your Son, Jesus Christ. We lift you. We lift up all the children, Lord God. All the mothers, all the fathers, the parents, those children who are leaving their homes, Lord, have mercy that they may come back and be united again. Bind the families with your love. Bind the couples with your love, with your peace, that they may look upon you as the head of their house, Lord God. This is our prayer in the most precious name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen, amen. Thank you, Sister Lai. Anybody else in the prayer line with a prayer request? Okay, may I call on Sister Cynthia?
Yes, Pastor Marina.
Hi, Sister Cynthia. I think we have to close.
Okay. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Amen.
Sons of God, march forward. Sons of God, march forward. Through the blood of Jesus. Sons of God, march forward. Through the blood of Jesus. It's such a long, long time since I sang that song. I've forgotten the words. Anyway, tonight we saw that we are the sons of God, propelled by a new belief system. So, Father God, we want to just thank you, O God, for letting us know that we are sons of yours. We will march forward because this new belief system will allow us, propel us to go forward. So we want to just thank you, Lord, when you designed it, O God, that when you would make us sons of yours because we believe in the word, Lord, that you already targeted our minds, O God. You would give us new minds, O God, the mind of Christ, O God. You had already targeted our hearts, O God, our hearts of faith, O God, the Father of our heart and give us a heart of flesh, O God. You had targeted, O God, because it is the world and the world system, O God, that had occupied our hearts and our minds. And Lord, you had targeted, O God, that you would deal with the devil. And your word let us know that you're going to put him away for 1,000 years. And you were targeted that your Son, Jesus Christ, will take preeminence in our hearts and our minds now. And, oh Lord, we become new creations, oh God, in Christ Jesus because of your new belief system, oh God, that will now shape our thoughts, oh God, will shape our character and shape our destiny. That finally, O God, we would have arrived, O God. Tonight we are thanking you, O Lord, for those who crossed over. Those whom you crossed over, Lord, we give you thanks. O God, we praise you, O God. When we look around us and about us and seen, O God, what could have been our portion had we not had faith in what we heard and surrendered to the power of the Holy Ghost. Lord, we thank you. And with all this being a son, we have inheritance, O God. Our inheritance is in Christ Jesus, your Son. Your Son, O God, who went to Calvary, O God. Your Son who bled at Calvary in our behalf, O God. Lord, we thank you, O God. How can we ever say thank you? Our thanks can never amount to anything. Because through your Son, O God, our inheritance, yes, divine health is our right. Your word let us know that you send your word and heal our diseases. And so tonight, your daughter cries out unto you, O God, you who have created our bodies, O God, and that, O Lord, no sickness or disease should overcome us, overtake us. So tonight we lift up your daughter.
This service is access code accepted. There are
6 participants in this conference. This conference is being recorded. Please announce yourself.
You have done it. It's laid up at Calvary, divine health of God. And so, Father God, we ask, oh Lord, that you will come down and take control. We want to just give everything over to you, oh God. Lord, we cannot carry this burden and we cannot carry it alone. We, oh Lord, turn it over to you, oh God. Have your own way in our lives. Lord, you are Jehovah Nissi, our protector. And as your daughter travels, oh God, that you would go with her, oh God. Traveling mercies, that you bless her going out and coming in. And as these two young men go to Nepal, Lord, I don't know their religious state, but it's not about religion. It's all about a relationship with you. I pray you would uncover yourself, that they would discover you, God, and know that you are God and that you are well able. Father God, I pray, and I know that you're going to bring them back safely because they go under the blood, your precious blood, and they will come back under your blood. And I pray, oh God, for their transformation, oh God, from just being children, but becoming a son of sons of yours. Father, we thank you, not only them, but their parents, the whole household, oh God. Oh Lord, we thank you, Lord, that also Margaret's household, oh God, will become sons of yours. Lord, we pray, oh God, for a mind of Christ, Lord. Oh Lord, we pray against that spirit of schizophrenia, whatever, oh God, spirit it is. You have given us not a spirit of fear, but of love and a sound mind. Visit her, oh God, in her state. Oh God, visit her, we beseech thee, and let her receive your forgiveness, oh God. And, oh, Lord, give her a new belief system, oh, God, that a sound mind would be her portion indeed, for it was atoned for at Calvary. Oh, Father, we give you thanks, oh, God. We thank you for your servants. We thank you again, oh, God, for all your servants on this land, oh, God, who are still the upkeep.
Yes, Lord.
Who are still holding your hand back from coming, Lord, coming forth. We know you're coming swiftly, but yet you have patience yet, willing that none should perish, but that all should come to repentance. Oh, Father God, save our loved ones, save our associates, save, oh God, those who when they hear the word, oh God, the faith was granted unto them, that initial faith to shoot out. Oh, Father, save them, as many as receive your word said, they became sons of yours. Have mercy, O God. Have mercy on this nation, O God. Have mercy, O God, upon those who are in the leadership roles, O God, who have the authority over us as leaders. Have mercy. Oh, God, you're willing that none should perish. Nevertheless, we trust you because we know that everything is in your control. You are God Almighty. Elohim is your name, God for every situation. Yes, you are Jehovah Jireh, Jehovah Nissi, Jehovah Shammah, Jehovah Ra, Jehovah Shekinah. You are Jehovah God in every situation. Tonight we declare your Lordship in our lives again. And we say thank you, O God. Thank you, thank you, thank you for grace, O God, to take the word forward. Lord, I thank you for all the souls that you are touching and bringing into the kingdom in these last days. Yes, they're surrendering. Oh, what a merciful God thou art. Lord, we give you thanks. We give you thanks. And we just close on us, oh God, that you continue to keep us and our loved ones, oh God. keep us, Lord. Keep us in all things. That you continue to be glorified in our lives, oh God. Let us bring you joy. Let the angels above rejoice, oh God, as the people come in. Thank you, oh God, to be a part of all this in these last days. We give you the praise. The honor awaits you. The glory is forever yours. In Jesus' name, we close. Mm-hmm. Amen.
Amen, amen. Thank you, Sister Cynthia. On behalf of Glory Tabernacle Healing and Deliverance Prayer Line, together with the Consuming Fire Radio Ministry, we bid you good night. Thank you all for coming in. And until we meet again on Wednesday, tomorrow is in Tagalog. Let's praise the Lord.